you are. We have to hurry before he finds me here.
Ryan, you guys at Camouflaj are in development on a brand new game called Republic. Take me into the game and what the setup is and what we're doing.
Well, the setup of the game is that you as a player are a part of the story, and then it's all about your communication, your relationship with this character in the game world named Hope. And your ability as a player is to be able to spy into this world that she's in and then give her advice and give her guidance and help her sneak and survive and get out of this facility that she's been stuck in her entire life.
This is sort of a genre-bending game. How would you describe it to somebody that's really well-versed in video game acronyms?
I actually think it's a hybrid genre between stealth action and survival horror. Hope, she's not an action hero, right? She is a girl who's never killed anybody, has never fought anybody before. So she has to sneak around this environment while also surviving and not having a bunch of ammo and like a rocket launcher to do it. It's gonna be really intense and you have to really think your way through it. It's almost like Splinter Cell meets Portal, mm-hmm. which I thought was a really interesting peanut butter and chocolate kind of analogy.
We're here in a mocap studio. This is sort of a unique thing to do for a touch-based game. What is motion capture bringing into Republic?
The fact that we're at motion capture, I think, shows that we're really serious, not only about the action making it look really great, but we have a really big story to tell. We have these characters, we want to bring them to life in a really lifelike, believable fashion. So we want to have almost like a TV episodic like experience on the phone. So anytime we tell people that, yeah, we're going to motion capture, I'm like, wait, aren't you doing stuff for like a touch-based device? It doesn't quite sync just yet, but we're hoping this is just the beginning.
You guys rely a lot on the use and the presence of cameras in this game. How is that going to impact the way the game looks?
It's a very much like a voyeuristic experience. You're viewing into this world through surveillance cameras and different Wi-Fi enabled devices. So it is influenced by what we're experiencing every day now. It's a little bit of a commentary about where we are in society. It's an interesting way of just viewing a game world before, where it's not behind the back, it's not first person.
Who are you hoping is attracted to this game? Obviously, core gamers are going to want to play this, but what about people that just pick up and play their mobile device? Are they going to want to play this game? Can they just jump into this game and pick it up and play it?
So one of the big challenges with the game that we're designing is that, yes, it's taking influences from really hardcore titles like Metal Gear and Resident Evil, obviously, but we're not using virtual joysticks. You know, we don't have tons of buttons. Well, the target audience initially is probably gonna be for the hardcore gamers that have seen like the pedigree of the stuff that I've worked on before, but it's opening it up to a whole new audience that can play the game because it doesn't require a lot of dexterity with like a DualShock controller and things like that.